first continental Africa, and it used to be in Israel until only about 100 years ago. Mm-hmm. You know Caesarea? Caesarea? Mm-hmm. It's the ancient Roman town that sunk into the Mediterranean, you know, between Haifa and Tel Aviv. So there used to be some crocodiles there until 1912. Nine crocodiles live and breed each male with 5 to 10 females. So we only have a few males in here, and most of them are females. And this biggest one, there is the bindle, of course, is a male. This is a male we cannot mistake. And it is the dominant male here. He is the king of the pond.
Okay.
And nine crocodiles, the few differences between the males and the females that we can see. The male nine crocodiles are larger than the females, but since crocodiles keep growing up throughout their lives, and they live for more than 100 years, even up to 150, they never stop growing up. So a much older female will be physically larger than a younger male. The males are also darker than the females, but here we also find lighter and darker families. We cannot tell only by that. The main difference we can see is the difference of proportions. And if we are looking at the head of the male crocodile, the width of the head, the end of the snout, and compare it to a female, we can see she's more delicate. No offense, mamas. But you see how big belly she has? Female crocodiles lay eggs once a year. The season here is at springtime. We expect it to start in about just more than a month from now. And at the season, each female chooses the place to lay her eggs. She digs a hole in the ground, in the sand, with her back feet. She lays from 30 to 60 eggs in a normal nest. It can even be nearly 100 in a very big one. Once a year, she lays all of her eggs at the same time. And then she covers them back with sand. She compresses it. And she stays there to guard the place. Crocodiles rented the eggs in our incubators. That is from the eggs we collected here. And we have here crocodiles aged from 5 to 15 years old. Some of them will start to lay eggs now. Just all of them in one area. This is a new pond.
So this sand is full of eggs?
Not yet.
But
at the moment, no one ever laid eggs here. It's all new. So it's going to be the first year now. We expect all of them to lay in this surface here.
Okay, how many females go there then?
Well, maybe 20 or 30.
Okay.
It's
quite crowded.
And we can see crocodiles are quite friendly amongst themselves, of course, not towards us. Many times we can see crocodiles lay their heads over another. They like to have a pillow or hand. And if a crocodile wants to move, he's not looking for a free pass, he just walks over its friends. And this is acceptable behavior for crocodiles, and no reason to fight, even if it causes inconvenience. And if you already know how to fight, the fight can start here at any time. And many times we can see crocodiles stay with the jaws open, looking for one. We don't see any. Nose is not allowed, but you cannot talk in you look at the back, you can see on the back there is a special structure. The lines of ridges, and each ridge is situated over a certain shape. It's got a margin line, square in the middle of the back, more round as we look at the rows going down the body. Each of these shapes is a bone scale. It is combined within the skin, so the crocodile has got a layer of bone scales all over its back. This whole layer is an addition, and it's not connected to the full skeleton. a crocodile has got in its body with the spine and all of the bones. Now, at the center of its bone scale is this ridge we can see, and that is to increase the surface towards the sun. There are many blood vessels going through these bones, and all of that system on the crocodile's back helps it get the most of the heat from the sun, just like a solar panel, and transfer it to their body. All of that is because crocodiles as reptiles are cold-blooded animals. They must adjust the body temperature using the environment. So a crocodile that's getting a little bit too hot opens its jaws and just stays like that to cool down. If it's warmer, it will be looking for shade. And if it's still too hot, it will go into the water. So whenever the temperature is extreme, all the crocodiles get into the water where the temperature is moderate and more convenient for them. And of course we can see it here, the cold hours of nights of winter and the very hot days of summer. The water is 3 meters deep. Sometimes we don't see any crocodiles. There is a huge water reservoir under us. We get the water from the Israeli Water Company, and they get it from 1,200 meters below.
1,200 meters.
Yes. This is the water we get here, and it comes warm from inside the ground.
Uh-huh.
So we get it between 30 to 40 Celsius degrees, which is just like spa water.
It's like in this one.
It's such a nature, it's unbelievable to have water.
Yes, and just under the desert, a lot of water. All of the agriculture, this is all value of agriculture. Exporting, it's only winter agriculture, because summer is too hot. So in the winter we export from this area. We grow to Europe, it all goes to Europe. All the beautiful tomatoes, the color, bell peppers. That's from all from this land. And it's all with this water from underground. It's a very advanced agriculture doing here.
How many kilos does big one weigh?
Well, this one about 100 kilos. Some more, some less, about 100. The big one we looked is nearly 1 ton.
1 ton?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But it's very big, it's nearly 5 meters long, and it's maybe 80, 90 years old.
Like we were in Florida from 10 years ago, and we saw all alligators, the big one was from 13 feet or something, also from 5, 6 meters, the bigger one.
Yes.
Oh my.
Yes.
Looks so friendly. So you go inside sometimes, but never.
It also looks like they're always smiling.
Yeah,
it is so very deceiving.
Yeah. But people never go in there.
Well, they can go in, it's possible.
Just
is different.
Just one way.
Yes.
One way.
One way ticket.
Yes, exactly.
But if something happens, some you have to, I don't know, rescue someone.
Yes, then we do. Then we have gates to see everywhere. We have gates from, if we want to get from any place, we can. So we use these red bars. You can see the red bar over the fence.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
We use these bars. We get the crocodiles away from us. We get them down to the water.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's easy to keep them in the water.
Mm-hmm.
We scare them to just stay down. But even get the
so
ice
you say
out
that
the
you
water.
Are very scary. And
yes.
Okay. So probably you don't sleep with them.